On this episode of the Scott Stedman Podcast, we're going to be looking at the theme of justice. How does justice play out, and especially what do we do when it seems like justice does not work for us on this world, or we suffer an injustice? Find out more here on the Scott Stedman Podcast.
Laying you down one last time. All machines that will never give.
Good afternoon and welcome to the Scott Stedman Podcast. My name is Scott. Obviously, it's my podcast. And it is a rainy day here in Stanton, Virginia. And this is the first podcast you're listening to off my hiatus. You should know that I have moved from Ohio to Virginia. So I'm in Stanton, Virginia now, and still unpacking boxes, still getting stuff all taken care of and ready. But for the most part, I'm really enjoying my time here, and that's great. Actually, yesterday I had a little bit of a scare. My wife was putting our son in the car to drive him around because he wasn't getting his naps in, and she wanted to try to get him to sleep, so she was driving around with him, and when I came home from work to go have lunch and do some shopping, I noticed that our dog was not in the house, and he was not outside on the chain. So I started calling for him, and I even called my wife and said, "Hey, did you happen to take Max with you?" And she's like, "No." It's like, well, he's not here in the house. And then I even noticed that his collar was missing too, which means I now have a missing dog with no collar, which is bad news. So I was screaming in the house for him. I ran outside screaming, went back into the house screaming, went back outside screaming. About the third time I finally went back outside and yelled for him, I actually saw him. He was actually by the church sign right next door to where I live. And I called for him, and he started running up to me, and I was so happy to see him, and I ended up giving him a treat. So hopefully he does not think that if he runs away, he gets treats. But, you know, that was a little bit of a heart attack that I had, but Max is safe, and actually it was nice that my son actually started to sleep through the night again, because he's been having a couple of issues the last couple of days. So my wife and I are very glad, and glad for that, and also we're glad for our mental health as well. But today I want to talk about justice, and just last week there was just a lot of different news stories coming out. Obviously, there was some more stuff in Ferguson, Missouri, and the whole racism issue over there. And, you know, it just seems like, you know, there's a lot of injustice that's happening over there. The big hot story last week was about the University of California in Irvine, basically voting to take down the American flag, and that caused a lot of controversy. But with all these, and there's a lot of other big news stories, but the one news story that really impacted me last week wasn't one that made national news or one that made international news. It actually was a story that made local news. It was actually, this article was on Cleveland.com. And apparently, the story is that a man was accused of abusing three young girls. And by abuse, it was basically he was charged with one count of rape and three counts of gross sexual imposition. And sure, there's stories like that all the time throughout the news, but the reason why this impacted me so much is the guy who's in prison was someone I knew from my high school. I went to school with him, graduated the same year with him. And the mother of the three girls, she was also somebody I went to school with. And both of them were my Facebook friends. They still are, but it was just one of those like surreal moments where you see these news stories and you see bad things happening and you're just like, oh man, you know, that's terrible. And then when you realize that it's actually someone you know, or who knows, maybe you're the one who's in the paper. It becomes real. It really hits close to home. And, you know, I was even just writing on my friend's page and just telling her, you know, I'm so sorry that this happened to your family. And, you know, I'll be praying for you and praying for healing and praying for guidance, and especially be praying for your three little girls who were victims in this assault. And it just broke my heart. And, you know, he has a court date, and according to the news report, he has admitted to police that he has done these things. So it seems like, you know, when he goes to court and everything, I'm assuming he's probably going to plead guilty, and he's going to be serving some time in jail for that. But then I started thinking about the concept of justice, and what is justice? You know, we have a whole justice department, and we have the courts, and we have the police, and we have lawyers, and there's all these people who their whole job is basically to make sure that justice happens. But what we have seen in the world that we live in is sometimes we have a lot of injustice that's happening. You know, very rarely I will read articles about how there was somebody who was in prison for 25 years and they finally found out that he was wrongfully imprisoned. And so he didn't have to serve those 25 years. So they let him escape. And you're just sad that, you know, there's so many people who in a way are innocent that get sent to jail. And there's so many people who have committed crimes, who have done wrong, and they end up getting off the hook. They get away scot-free. And you're just wondering, like, you know, if justice is so important into the world and making sure that, you know, as far as for the protection of the citizens who live in a community, that justice shall be done, then what do we do when something happens that an injustice happens? What happens when we're seeking justice and that never happens, or the justice that we want never comes through? So that's really hard, and that's very difficult for people to understand. And, you know, I was just even thinking about, there was a guy at my church that I was attending in Ohio, and it was actually quite a sad story. He was an older gentleman, and he was having problems with his computer, and he's just like, you know, I'm just going to go get a computer. So he started looking at Craigslist. He's like, well, maybe I can get a good computer but not have to buy a new computer, because he didn't have much money. So he ended up buying this computer off a guy, and he set it up, and it was still running a little bit faster, but not so much. Well, one day he's just on the internet, and he happened to get this random email, and he clicked on it, and it just happened to be, he was just like, oh, well, this must be junk. So he ended up deleting the email. Well, then it was actually Easter. It was Easter Sunday. He just came home from church, and he's laying down for a nap. And then FBI agents start busting through the house. They ended up confiscating the computer that he bought off Craigslist. And when the FBI was searching that computer, they found a bunch of child pornography on the computer. And the man was saying, you know, I don't know where that came from. I actually bought the computer off of Gong's Craigslist. He tried to go back and look at his orders, but since Craigslist looks like it's from the 1990s, as far as how they set up things, he couldn't find any proof or anything or even have a name. So he ended up going to court, and I guess, you know, his lawyer kind of flubbed up his case, and he ended up serving time in a federal prison. And I forget how long. He didn't end up serving his full term. He was at one place. He went to another place. And then he ended up getting off. But I think he served 15 years, almost 15 years of a life sentence. So basically half a life sentence in prison. And I just remember hearing that story, and I'm just like, wow, like, how did that happen? Like, that's such a, you know, something shouldn't happen, especially if it wasn't his fault. And it was just crazy. And I think sometimes people get bummed out that, you know, when injustice happens to them, especially with everything that's happening with Ferguson, especially with the race issue, you know, there's so many people who are of a different culture and of a different race who feels like that there's an injustice when somebody who is higher up than them can push their authority or basically push their color onto them and cause an injustice. So what do we do? How do we solve this issue? Well, I've been reading a book. It's a book called Justice Awakening by Eddie Bunn. And it's actually a book that I got for free. And it basically, the whole part of this book is basically how can your church help end human trafficking? So a lot of this stuff is focused on human trafficking. However, in the very first chapter, it talks about God's passion for justice. And it's very interesting about how there is a God of justice out there who wants justice. And it's very interesting. If you look at certain passages like Proverbs 29:26, many seek the face of a ruler, but it is from the Lord that a man gets justice. So again, justice does not necessarily come from man. It comes from the Lord. Psalms 37:28, for the Lord loves justice. He will not forsake his saints. They are persevered forever, but the children of the wicked shall be cut off. So then again, another thing of Lord loving justice. Obviously, God desires to seek justice. Hosea 12:6. So you, by the help of your God, return, hold fast to love and justice, and wait continually for your God. Amos 5:15, hate evil and love good and establish justice in the gate. It may be that the Lord, the God of hosts, will be gracious to the remnant of Joseph. And Micah 6:8, he has told you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? But to do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with your God. So we see that there is this idea that God loves justice. He's always seeking for justice. And sometimes it might be hard for us to see that, you know, to find justice in this world. But we also have the security of knowing that, you know, eventually God's justice is going to come through. The judge may mess up. The lawyer may mess up. You know, humans are so susceptible to error that sometimes that's how injustice happens. But we also know that there's a God who loves justice, and he's always working to bring good into the world, and he's always ringing to bring justice, especially for those who have suffered injustice at the hands of man. So that's really all I have to speak about today. So I guess, you know, again, thank you for listening. And hopefully this podcast was able to lift up your spirits a little bit, especially if you're listening and you're someone who has suffered some type of injustice in your life. Hopefully you can have security in knowing that there's a God out there who's always working in your best interest, so that justice will be served. All right, well, I hope you all have a great day, and I will have another podcast for you soon. All right, talk to you later. Bye.